I'm going to jump for this deck. To go there. Well, well, well. Thank you.
the station.
Thank you.
mission critical message.
Thank you.
Operation complete. Dispatching ground crew. Greetings, Commander.
Detected.
Thank you.
Mandalay released. Zorgan Peterson's SCO-friendly explorer ships out. The first run of Mandalay ships has been delivered to shipyards across the core systems and are now available for purchase. Zorgan Peterson's Mandalay is the third new vessel to be optimized for Achilles Aerospace's SCO frame shift drive, following the Python Mark II and the Type 8, and aims to become the premier medium-sized exploration craft. Chief Marketing Officer Devin Canada sent a press statement to all shipyard outlets. The Mandalay allows pilots to achieve a considerable jump range while maintaining the maneuverability of its size class, expanding the range of future exploration voyages of its size class. Our technicians have ensured that the ship's handling in atmospheric conditions is exceptional, easing the travel down to undiscovered worlds. A rethink of structural stress resistance, in cooperation with Achilles engineers, has resulted in the Mandalay taking full advantage of the SCO frame shift drive. We believe this vessel is an exceptional package for pilots who wish to explore the galaxy efficiently, comfortably, and in style. Notable at the Mandalay's release party was the lack of a representative of Sirius Corporation. Rumors of an ongoing disagreement between representatives and Zorgan Peterson management over Achilles' design input have grown in volume in recent weeks. President Winters assumes office. The inauguration ceremony has taken place to formally swear in Felicia Winters as the President of the Federation. President Winters made a public address from the White House in Olympus Village on Mars. I pledge to work for the benefit of each and every individual within our Federation. My administration will redirect funding away from corporations toward improving health, public services, and quality of life. Together, we will launch a new era of optimism and opportunity. My first act is to order the Federal Intelligence Agency to shut down the Proactive Detection Bureau. The illegal surveillance of all communication ends now. We will propose to Congress that the Domestic Counterterrorism Act of 3307 is revoked, allowing our federal accord to uphold each citizen's constitutional right to privacy. The presidential election was held in October 3309, when Felicia Winters eclipsed her rival Jerome Archer by 4% of the vote. Her inauguration was delayed for a number of reasons, including the personal tragedy affecting the Winters family after disastrous earthquakes on Rhea 3. President Winters is supported by Vice President Isilda Rochester, matriarch of the famous Rochester family. The Liberal Party will now form a new federal government, led by a hand-picked cabinet. This includes Congressman Christine Lasky as Secretary of State, Con Montgomery as Secretary for Defense, Bai Zheng as Secretary for Security, and Pierre Marc Peltier as Grand Attorney. Former President Zachary Hudson has officially vacated the office, having served since 3301. His successor, Shadow President Jerome Archer, will now lead the Republican Party as the opposition. Famed treasure hunter Herman Colt missing. A prominent figure in the treasure hunting community has gone missing, prompting speculation as to his fate. Herman Colt, known for recovering several notable historical artifacts across the core systems, departed the Frenis system 3 weeks ago along with several other pilots. It is believed Colt's latest expedition sought the final treasure hoard of Captain Morrigan, a fearsome pirate active in the mid-3200s. Rewired spoke to a colleague of Colt's, Natasha Moore, for an insight into Colt's whereabouts. It's unlike Colt to maintain radio silence during an expedition. In fact, it's fair to say he loves the attention. Each new expedition generates buzz among the exploration community, with dozens of pilots begging to be taken along for the adventure. Colt has a soft spot for Captain Morrigan. I think he's already got some bits and pieces from her life on display at his home. I know he was excited about this trip, and the chance to find Morrigan's final treasure stash. But typically Colt would have sent me an update by now. Hopefully he's just having too much fun on his latest voyage. Captain Morrigan was known for a series of daring raids between 3253 to 3261, with her gang often overpowering significantly larger forces to steal cargo from trade convoys in and around Frenis. Her most significant rivals belonged to the Candira gang, and firefights between the two groups were common. was last sighted in 3265, and it is believed she died in action around this time. Thargoid War Bulletin, the last mothership. Titan Rigen in the Pegasus Sector IHUB-33 system has been destroyed, leaving only Kosiho still operational. Aiden Tanner, anti-Xeno strategist for Aegis, provided a brief statement. My heart still soars to hear that another Titan has been taken down. Until very recently, these colossal constructs were seen as indestructible. Aegis was even drawing up long-term strategies based around them being permanently present in human space. The Guardian Nanite torpedo, and the hard work of so many pilots, has made that academic. Anti-Xeno pilots are already traveling to the systems surrounding Col 285 Sector BAPC-618 to repeat the process one last time on Titan Kosiho. With such a concentrated effort, it is not expected to last long. However, I must repeat my earlier call for caution and preparedness. We cannot tell how the Thargoids will respond to the loss of their last mothership, and we may face unknown weaponry or tactics. Seo Jin A Awake releases unauthorized warning. Reports that Aegis Special Advisor Seo Jin A has woken from a week-long coma were followed by a statement by Seo, which was sent to all major news feeds. Aegis medical personnel had confirmed earlier in the day that Seo had abruptly woken from unconsciousness following a significant seizure on October 18th. There were no long-term physical concerns, and she was expected to make a full recovery. However, less than 2 hours later, Seo released a statement via Icecast. The raw footage was self-recorded and is believed to have been made without Aegis Command's authorization. I hate making these public announcements, so don't expect it to be good, she explained. But everyone keeps telling me how important I am to the war effort, so why not test that and see if anyone listens? There's something everybody needs to know. What happened to me wasn't an accident or an illness. Right before I passed out, there was a noise in my head. It was like someone plugged an amplifier straight into my brain. I couldn't stop it, and it hurt like you wouldn't believe. It's still echoing in my skull somewhere. But more than that, I could feel it moving through my consciousness.
My...
navigation system is very messy to my eyes. Supposed to be in the third millennium, and it looks like it has been built in 1994.
offline. Our facilities are at your disposal, Commander.
Please exit the station safely and promptly.
System scan complete. at 4-2. You're approved for automated docking sequence.
Thank you for watching. I had some monitor issues. It's a bit wild at the moment, so thank you for watching and see you next time with new adventures. Bye.